Hotel stocks, that's one space you need to focus on. They are buzzing in trade today after the GST Council cut the rates on hotel tariffs above 7,500 rupees to 18% from 28%. Rates and tariffs up to 7,500 rupees was cut to 12% from 18%. Let's discuss the prospects of this move with Vishal Kamat of Kamat Hotels. He's joining us right now. Vishal, thanks very much for taking out the time. How big is this an incentive for the entire industry?
I think it's a great move. I thank the government for an excellent Happy Diwali for not just the industry, but even the consumers. Because at the end of the day, the kind of heavy taxation which the end consumer was paying was pinching his experience and his holiday. And I think the Diwali couldn't be better for everyone.
For Kamat Hotels, could you just highlight for me what was the current tax bracket and, you know, post the announcements, post GST as well as the corporate tax coming down to about 25% odd, you know, what would it work out to be for Kamat Hotels, the savings, and would you avail, because, you know, there is a choice whether you stick to the current, SOPs that the industry gets and the current levies that the industry gets, or then you move to the 25% tax bracket. So what is the game plan for Kamat Hotels?
So regarding that, definitely our people are working on that aspect, but I'd like to address the GST part of the first part of your question. See, there is nothing to gain for hoteliers by a cut in terms of any savings in GST. But what we will gain is increased business, because a lot of good and a lot of value-added products become more affordable for a larger audience of guests. Also, we become a preferred choice when it comes to, you know, the 28% tax coming down to 18% and 12%. I think that is something which will encourage even more travel and trade tourism, especially when we look at the foreign season. We have lost this season, so whichever guests come and enjoy our hospitality this year is okay, but it will prep the travel agents, it will prep the hoteliers for the next season of the gestation period would be a little longer for foreign travelers to get the benefit of the GST. The current ones who have already booked, they will get some benefit, but by and large I think the industry will definitely and we see that in our bookings, we see that in not just our bookings, we see that in general sentiments that have been echoed, you know, amongst even our other clients and customers who feel happy that, you know, something which was a cash strain for them or a tax strain for them has now become something more rational. So I think the sentiments are very upbeat for hoteliers, because many of our hotels like Fort Jadavgarh, the Orchid Mumbai or our other hotels were falling in mostly the 18 and the 28 bracket. So that has become a big relief to us. And I hope that systematically the government will, looking at how they have done now, they will make it even more simplified towards a single tax structure and, you know, make it more easier for our industry and our customers.
You know, just to go back to my previous question, what is the current tax bracket for, you know, Kamat Hotels?
So we were in MAT, but now that we've been, we will be out of MAT soon because of the profits that we've been generating over the last few years. And now we will go into the various tax bracket. So we'll be out of MAT.
Vishal, safe to assume that earlier MAT was 18, then the effective rate was somewhere about 20, which in itself has been lowered from 18 to 15 now. So you also stand to benefit, right?
Definitely. We would definitely stand to benefit, and we would use those proceeds wisely to look at our various plans which are already there in place and use it to fuel economic growth as what the government expects.
Okay, so the savings that you make through paying less taxes because the MAT rates have also come lower, will that be used to reinvest your expansion plans? Will you look to revisit whatever expansion plans were laid out at the start of this financial year?
Most of it we will be looking at in terms of repaying our lenders also, and bringing down further debt burden, and also reusing some of that money for enhancing our current properties, because the season is coming and we're, you know, looking at refurbishment, which we are already doing in some of the cases. So this will help in easing that cash flow also.
Deleveraging. So the GST rate cut, of course, it's a big sentiment booster. I'm sure the company doesn't gain in itself, but tell us, will this lead to occupancy rates as well? What is the current occupancy rate for your properties? And with the cut in GST rate, how much improvement do you expect ahead of the festive season?
So generally, our hotels do anywhere between 70 and 85%, depending on location to location, city to city. In some of the resort destinations, it's even as low as 55. But then that's also because the yields are higher. Like Fort Jadavgarh is a premium destination. It does about 55, 58% occupancy year round. But then the stay price is much higher, you know, anywhere between 11 and 14,000 rupees, depending on the packages that you take. Same way in the city, Mumbai. Mumbai is a very busy metropole, and because of that, you know, more almost throughout the year there is a movement, so you find occupancies in the high 80s. But then again, I think the main benefit, I think, which we will see in the long run is the improvement in ARR due to the decreased taxation, because now holistically we've become more attractive. It would probably help hoteliers in cities like Mumbai, where the ARR has not grown in tandem with the way it should have. This could be an opportunity for us hoteliers to be able to take advantage of this rate cut and help improve our ARR, because at the end of the day, the ARR is as important as occupancy, if not more.
So
because
what extent, since
in our country, you can always be full, but at what price?
Got your point. Since you mentioned ARRs and you said there'll be an improvement, you know, when you're talking about the long term, you know, are you referring to about 2 to 3 years down the line? And, and how much would the improvement be on ARR? If you can quantify?
I hope it doesn't take 3 years. I would ideally like it to improve much faster. But this ARR is a function of the market. So definitely we will assess the market. We will see how we are. We will see how our competitors are. We will see also the market sentiments in terms of how, you know, there's already a challenge in terms of getting rooms in certain markets. And definitely hoteliers would like to take advantage of that, because all this time we've come through a very tough period and we see better days in hospitality now. So definitely we would like to build on our ARR. I hope it will not take 3 years, and I don't think it should, but definitely in the near future, we would definitely like to make sure that we have an improved ARR along with a sustained high occupancy.
All right, Vishal, we'll leave it at that. Thank you very much for joining us. Appreciate you taking out the time.